So in percentage terms, that's 59% increase over those 7 years. And obviously, we've got central government funding, we've got local funding via the council tax bills. And I guess over time, that sort of ebbed and flowed, although it seems to be one directional in recent years. Can you give us a comparative figure, or you know, roughly a comparative figure, as to how the government contribution, if you like, the central government contribution over that 7 year period, how much that has increased compared to what members of the public have been asked to increase, and Band D in particular, that 59% figure?
Many thanks for attending today in support of this item, which has been really useful and Thank you, Chair. So this is all about the driving change, which is very much about how we kind of change that revolving door that we know people want to get some confused in the criminal system. How do we get upstream? How do we prevent crime from happening in the first place? So there's a lot in here about the work of the kind of prevention works and about structured partnership, which, you know, I've reported on previously, but just outlining some of the key events that we funded through that. My youth diversion fund, which again I have reported on previously to the panel, but some of the projects that we funded to try and reduce the impact of social behaviour in particular. There's also some detail in there around the work of local authorities and the community safety partnerships. So you'll remember that I give every community safety partnership a grant to deliver on various priorities. A lot of that feeds into this priority as well, in terms of trying to prevent kind of social behaviour and crime coming into young people. There's lots of detail information there. And then there's also some stuff in there around the work we're doing around mental health and substance misuse. Obviously, as colleagues might be aware around the changes that are being discussed nationally around right care, right person, and how we you know, redirect those who are suffering mental health crisis to the right agency and in terms of health as opposed to the police. So there's work on the way to consider how that's going to be implemented here on the Merseyside. And then there's also information on the Combined Drugs Partnership, which and June's leading for me, and I'm sure I'm happy to answer any detailed questions about that. It's looking at how we could, a combination of, you know, police enforcement and going after the criminal gangs who sell drugs, but also trying to look at how we can work with our public health partners to divert people who are struggling with drug issues to into rehabilitation services. So lots of information there, but happy to take some questions, Chair.
Thank you, Commissioner.
Is there any feedback on the social behaviour survey that you carried out?
In December.
Regarding the values and the effect of disappointment from the results of the unsocial behaviour survey has not been received from the home office.
I don't think we have that yet, have we? Is this one the one the home office would do? They were, that's the problem to find out what they were coming to ask questions, and obviously we've been doing some work around social behaviour and the community justice pilots, where people who are committing social behaviour are then put to kind of work to make amends in terms of cleaning up an area or painting a fence or something. So I think it's linked to that, but I don't think we've had the detailed feedback at all, so we'll follow that up.
Thanks.
Thanks, Chair. This one refers back to your report on the precept, but it's relevant to this. It's the allocation of the Community Safety Fund. Now, in the precept report, I think if I've interpreted the table, which is on page 26, correctly, the funding is effectively frozen. 2023-24, and the proposed allocations for 2024-25 are the same. Has there been discussions with the five authorities or leaders from the five authorities? Are they, or have they been notified that funding is being frozen?
Yes, so what's previously happened is that there's been one-off yearly agreements, and every year we have, you know, we're trying to notify them about what the what the allocation is going to be. What I've tried to do this year is recognise that there's no additional funding to go into this because this is all part of the wider, you know, police budget. And so recognising that there isn't any more investments given to it. What we've decided to do is through multi-year funding. So although the grant is staying the same, we are reforming the community safety partnership, so we'll be getting it for the next 3 years. So including this year. So actually, we're trying to give them some stability, so at least then the impact of what they can deliver, they can plan a bit further ahead, might be easier in terms of recruitment and things like that. So the grant is staying the same, which I'm pleased about because it's as much a part of the savings challenges as all the rest of the budget is. But I'm really committed to keep it safe for the next 3 years so that the local authorities can plan ahead.
Okay, that's fine. And just to flip a little bit, the Merseyside Violence Reduction Partnership, and those page 58, is it you talk about a website has recently been honoured, and it's picked up an award. Are you or anyone in the team able to give us a few details about the award? And also, I was curious, I've looked at the website, and it's always difficult with websites because you're pitching at a particular audience, and I got the feeling there's quite a lot of stuff on there that I think is pitched probably to partners, you know, the sort of jargony language. So I'm just wondering what the primary audience is, as well as finding out a little bit more about what the award was.
So I think the award was for the accessibility of the website, probably, in terms of how it was very understandable by those who were those commissions, and you know, it was just a very accessible website, which I think is the aim, and so they'll probably give you some suggestion around, you know, we want it to be as transparent and accessible to everybody, we want everybody to know the work that they're doing for the Marshall Partnership. I think we recognise that it might appeal to a certain group of board members, and that might include partners who want to know what kind of work we're doing. So it's not the only way. We also do a lot of work to you know, work on our social media, using videos, doing press releases, you know, we try and work really hard to try and promote the public or the projects that are being funded through the Marshall Partnership. But I think in terms of having a one-stop shop that summarises the real impact of what the VRP is doing, that's what we try to do, and I think that's what was recognised as part of the award.
I've got a couple of questions, Commissioner. First one was in relation to the substance misuse initiative, intensive supervision report, sorry. We wonder if there's been any evaluation taking place to see the impact on rehabilitation counselling of offenders.
There hasn't yet, but will be. So this is a Ministry of Justice funded pilot to look at putting intensive, this is what it says, it's intensive supervision for individuals who are struggling with misuse, and then they have regular meetings with the judiciary and the courts, who will try and kind of just support them on that journey and, you know, hold them accountable a bit, but in a way it's kind of supportive. So we've actually got a visit coming up in a couple of weeks, and the minister's coming up to have a look and see what we're doing, and it's still very early days, but we'll be full evaluation as part of that, so we can certainly report on that once the Ministry of Justice concludes it.
Another one from me. The Merseyside Fire Champions programme at Merseyside Fire, so we're interested. Delivered in partnership with the Police and Ambulance Service, has commenced. Do we know how many young people engage with the programme, and does support continue with the individuals following the 6-week programme?
So it says there we've had almost 300 young people, 9 to 10 year olds, who have engaged in that. I'm not aware that there's any specific ongoing engagement with the intervention itself, but I think as part of any intervention that we do as part of our Action Partnership, we would seek to ensure that there is a, you know, follow through to support the school or education or whatever it might be. But yeah, about 300 people.
That's really good. Lisa?
Who's me? That is a good question. I just don't remember pressing the button too much. Yeah, just a comment really. This report, again, I'm always impressed with how varied your work is and the work in the office. And I think this report, you know, illustrates that. So it's not so much a question, but just to acknowledge, you know, the breadth and the depth of the work that you oversee. Thanks.
Commissioner, could I ask if there could be something else included in the report going forward? I've talked to you a few times about the youth works apprenticeships.
Oh, yes.
The first cohort has now graduated, most of them are with level 3, and most of them are going on to level 6, which is almost degree level, well, it is degree level. And that's when the use of the apprenticeship levy really comes into its own, because you could get a degree without the fees cost. So that's good. And the second cohort started about 2 weeks ago. And the reason I mention them, because that has got off the ground with money from the Violence Reduction Partnership. And this year I think we've got some money from them and from the Liverpool City Council, amongst others. Yeah. So I just think that is a really good piece of work that could be sitting in here as well, if possible. Members, have you any more questions on this? Thank you. Therefore, we're happy to agree the report, and if it could be recorded, that we've endorsed it. Thank you. 3C, Commissioner's Plan for Maternity. Congratulations. Commissioner, do you want to talk us through this report?
Yes, so this is obviously a first. I'm the first PCC to be having a baby, so what we've kind of navigated is we've had discussions that there isn't any guidance anywhere. Nobody could have envisioned that a PCC could possibly often have a baby, so we're testing the water a little bit, but it's just providing some reassurance that in terms of the workload of the office and what kind of priorities are being set, that will continue. So it just gives you an outline as to how things work. This is very much how it would work if I was to pick, you know, if I was to be taken ill or anything like that, which is Jean will also be around with my deputy and with support from Sue and Don and the rest of the office to make sure that things are moving forward. There were only a couple of areas where only I am legislatively able to, where I can't delegate it, but we don't expect any of those coming up during my time that I'll be off. So it's just providing reassurance that we've got plans in place to make sure that it continues.
Thank you, Commissioner. Any questions, members?
Thanks, Chair. Can I just say, I'm sure everyone will agree that we wish you all the very best for you and your baby.
Thank you.
Thanks, Chair.
Not going
to get
on.
No.
I think there is that need for reassurance, and I think it's a good report, Commissioner. I think our difficulty will be a bit further down the line after the elections and whatever, but we can't prejudge what will happen then. Is everybody reassured by that report? Therefore, we endorse it and thank you. Next item is your decisions, Commissioner. Could you take us through that before? Thank you.
Yes, thank you, Chair. So, just a handful of decisions since we last met, a couple of disposals around estates and some updates around some of the victim services. But, as always, happy to take questions.
Are we any questions on this round of decisions? Peter?
Chair. Just curious, with the disposal of Canning Place, I mean, for a long, long time, it would be recognised that the police headquarters will be moving. It has now successfully moved. Of course, it's such a prime piece of land. In terms of, I know you've had a campaign, that we've PR campaign, asking people to have their say. Is it likely, in your view, that the building would be retained for a different purpose, or are we talking about the plot of land being sold?
We're not putting any specific restrictions on it at this point. As you say, we started the soft modeling exercise, which is very much trying to understand what the public might like to see there, so that when we come to officially put it on the market, we have the right kind of brief around the type of developer that we want to sell it to. So we're not making any restrictions at this moment around whether the building stay there or not. I think in initial discussions we've had, there were pros and cons for either way, depending on what it is that goes there. So we're not making any commitments to it at this point. That would be for whatever comes out of the brief.
Has there been any indication, even in general terms, as to how much that plot of land is worth?
There is, but I think probably for commercial sensitivities it would be wise to say out loud.
That's why I said in general terms.
So we have done that piece of work, and we are kind of conscious of market value and things like that. But as I say, I was really keen that because it's such an iconic site, while I want to make sure we get a good return on it to help us, you know, from the rest of the estate strategy, I want to make sure that we leave a positive legacy in terms of what places it. So we're going to go for the weekend.
More side things to make right decision when we
purchase it.
That's fine, thanks. Is that another question, Peter?
No, sorry.
Any other questions on this? I think the management of the estates and to do so efficiently can help in so very many ways. Thanks for that report, Commissioner. Can we endorse that, please? Thank you. Item 4, governance arrangements and update on the issues and recommendations made by the Commissioner. Commissioner, can you take us through this report, please? Thank you.
Yes, thank you, Chair. So just 3 actions from the last meeting. I think we've now responded to all of them in various ways, hopefully to address the issues, particularly rural. But again, happy to pick up any questions or issues.
safe journey, everybody. Good luck. Just in case.